Alright guys, this is part 14. This mission is called the Black Khazar, I believe. And we are now at Vice. So yeah, we've been promoted. I suggest you check out the previous video. It was a long one, I admit.
This is your new partner, Roy Earl. Take a seat. A special request was made to transfer you to add Vice. We need a man with your kind of starch on this desk, son. We have two dead Negroes found in an apartment this morning on Yucca Street. Number 6358, apartment 5.
We got better things to be doing than wasting our time on two dead junkies.
Did I ask your opinion, detective? Two men dead on U.S. Army issue morphine. That makes it an advice case. Beat it!
Yes, sir.
All right.
You and the lieutenant have some history?
You could say that. We used to be partners. So, you're working with the big boys now, Cole?
I guess so, Roy. I thought homicide was the primo assignment.
That may be the case. I asked for you personally, Phelps. I had to pull a few strings to get you over to Advice. How does it feel?
The lieutenant seems to think I'm doing okay.
Okay. Don't get humble on me, Phelps. You're doing great. You're the department pinup boy. War hero and crime fighter. What a combination.
I can assure you I'm no war hero, detective.
All right, so the next mission...
Let's rouse some hopheads.
No offense,
you drive.
Man, you drive.
I need to go over the case notes. Nice car, Roy. Is that department issue?
No, this is my sled. You can't be seen slumming it in a Nash if you're in Vice, Colt. Meanwhile, we got needle freaks kissing it goodbye all over Central Avenue.
So there's an ongoing drug epidemic in the city. If there's any copyrighted music in this, I may have to remove it, guys. So it is what it is, just to give you fair warning. I don't know how long this case is going to go on for, so... Each video varies, but it's often an hour, at least in my experience of this game thus far.
They really picked a prize shithole for our first date.
Yeah.
It's up the
Officer,
stairs, detective.
Please tell me what's
around
going
the corner,
on.
Last door on the left.
Alright. Have I got a new suit on? Looks pretty nice. Snazzy. Snazzy, sorry, is what I'm looking for.
I'm all done. Your show now.
Carruthers.
Phelps?
I've been reassigned to Advice.
What have we got? Two stiffs, overdosed, been dead a couple of days.
Government issue morphine? We use the same syrettes in Okinawa.
Fucking Negro junkies can't take supply this pure.
You know these guys?
I know of them. The younger one's a two-bit horn player by the name of Cornell Tyree. The other one works in distribution. Started using a little too much of his own product, and Jack D took exception. He wasn't born that ugly. His name's Lamont. Tyrone Lamont.
So who's supplying the drugs?
That's easy. Whoever knocked off the wharves in San Pedro. Jack Dragna, Mickey Cohen. Dope's been all upside down ever since Jimmy Utley started the long walk at Quentin.
You talk about it like it's a system.
It was a system. But those days are long gone.
We are supposed to uphold the law.
Yeah, and we do. But we can't change people. The truth is, everyone wants the license to get a little dirty now and then. Our job is to keep it manageable.
That's how you see it?
See it any other way, and you better forget about being a vice cop.
Can we get on with this? Today, preferably?
Why would you invite me into Vice if you knew it was a corrupt game and I wouldn't go for it? You know the kind of man I am.
One syrette is enough to knock you out for combat trauma. Two of them will stop your heart.
Damn. Nothing about the face, no wounds, just looks like a drug overdose in general. I don't see what we can find from the body.
You catch all the good ones, Phelps.
Oh.
Looks like it was always going to end this way.
Yeah. Alright, so that's proof in the pudding, as it were. Ah, contacts. Maybe his dealer's in here. Cornell,
they say
Curry.
Only the good die young. I hope it was true in your case.
Yeah. Race. Look what it's got there. Wow, I'm not going to say it. 1946. Okay.
Just when I think I've seen it all.
Nope. Got to go back in the wallet. Damn it. I forgot to look to the right side.
Must have been messy.
There was a piece of paper.
It's all over the floor.
What's this note? JJ always listened.
Who is JJ? And why do these two care about his taste in music?
Hmm. 275 FM. Had a couple of bucks.
Another day, another dollar.
That's it. All right. The hell?
Black Caesar. From a joint across the street.
Okay, so they got some coffee.
Like something was taped to the bottom of the cup.
Ah. Is that how they're distributing the drugs? Go get some popcorn and underneath it is taped the drugs? That's all I could think right now. So, the Black Caesar or whatever is a front. I'm surprised if he was an addict, he didn't sell these off. If he needed money for drugs, possibly. Well, he does play music. Aren't there two bodies? Yeah, there is. Ah, here we go. Another cup. They both have popcorn. Or drugs.
Tyrone Lamont. Not even 23 years old.
Jesus.
Find anything interesting?
Payout on 746 Saturday night.
No chance in life is probably better than no chance.
Wait, what was that? 746 Saturday night. Okay. Trying to remember that, but there's a cup here, so this is what I'm thinking about for drugs. They both had some popcorn, and of course,
another special order from the Caesar.
Yes, indeed. Underneath, I can't see underneath, it's not letting me inspect it. Oh, yeah, there it is. Boom. I bet you if I went to go buy some popcorn, that tape wouldn't be there. It's just simply a front. Before we get to the body.
Just when I think I've seen it all.
Some kind of fruit, a bell, and wind. Strange doodle.
So, those might be to a machine. Fruit, bell, wind. It might be the name of something to bet on, a horse. Or something. It's something to do with gambling. There's a lot of gambling stuff here. Or that could just be the symbols in a slot machine. But why doodle them? Unless it's a scam somehow.
Never the same, are they?
Wow, they've got a lot of popcorn here. Must be really big fans of the stuff. Yes, indeed. There's a lot of evidence here, boy. What's this? All in my head.
What's the correlation between love of the needle and love of the music?
No clue.
Just when I think I've seen it all.
Drug addict musicians. Pretty standard these days, surely. Oh! Here we go.
Street life have no idea how dangerous this stuff is.
Morphine threat, okay. They used to inject or carry, whatever.
No cooking or preparation. Must have been the easiest fix these two ever had.
And again, the cup. So, as far as I'm concerned, right away, we're looking at...
Special order from the Caesar.
We're looking at a drugs front. We've got to investigate that place right away. Raid that bitch. Check underneath for popcorn. Straight away, this is fucking an interesting case.
Bit heavy for an empty cup.
This one's got one underneath it. Yes, indeed.
Getting their fix right over the counter in broad daylight.
Perfect. So where's his supplier? I would stake them out and watch their supplier. Who brings the popcorn? There's a shitload of them. It's ridiculous.
Took his jolt and drifted off. And I suppose his friend wasn't in any condition to notice that he had stopped breathing.
Agreed.
The Emperor across the street appears to shift a lot of popcorn. Let's shake him down.
Yes, indeed. Movie night every night at that house. Man, we're gonna find a shitload. We're gonna have to threaten him and everything. Where is this dude? Hold on. Where are we? The Black Caesar.
Let's wrap this up before I actually have to work overtime instead of just claiming for it.
You're a true inspiration to us all, Roy.
Okay, calm down. Jesus.
Help you?
Detectives Phelps and Earl, LAPD. We're inquiring into the deaths.
Hand over the popcorn, numbskull, before we kick the door in.
He made a run for it. Okay, I cannot run. Oh, R2. It's been a long time since I had to run. So he's just a drug pusher. We'll find out who the supplier is, motherfucker. I would have asked for some special popcorn, and then we would have had him right there and then, like, supplying drugs to me, a cop, you know, undercover. So we would have charged him for drug supplying. Supplying drugs. But the reality of it is that he is just a pusher. He's not the man behind it. So, man, this guy can run. I will shoot your ass to stop you. Oh!
Eddie, help me out, man. They're trying to kill me. You gotta help me out.
What the hell going on here? Morgan! Not you?
You picked the wrong cop, you fucking animals.
Oh. Made me lose my hat and everything. That's a trophy as well. Ah. Bitch.
I'm gonna beat you black and blue.
Oh shit. Oh. Fuck. Control is so fucking awkward.
Come on then.
Bitch. Finish him, yeah, bitch.
What's your name?
Morgan.
Half an answer is no answer to me, asshole.
Fleetwood Morgan.
Keep an eye on him, Roy, while I take a look around.
I helped myself to some popcorn and a burger. I don't know, I'm starving. Fleetwood.
Don't give me an excuse to shoot you.
Okay. Now this should be interesting. What is this?
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that.
No, nothing.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
Alright. Do-do-do, special branch of their popcorn. Oh, hold on.
Morphine. Might not be filling, but I'm sure it's satisfying.
And of course, okay. So who delivers them? That's what I'd like to know. A shitload of cash? Is this the drug money? Okay.
Should be stamped on the reverse by the issuer.
Ah. Jermaine Jones, booking agent.
Give us something on this Jones character.
So it seems to be associated with the blues. Or the jazz club, as it were. Or like two of them are musicians. This guy's got this here.
These number slips might affect your tone, Fleetwood.
Payout on 625. Wednesday night. I think that's about it.
About time we heard what Fleetwood here has to say, Cole.
Yeah, we're gonna have to have a little word now.
I'm at a loss.
Get the kid's story.
We're inquiring about the deaths of two men in an apartment across the street, Fleetwood. We want answers.
Of course. I'll do my best, mister.
You sold the drugs to Cornell Tyree and Tyrone Lamont.
Oh, I sell fried steaks and black eyed peas.
What?
You're lying, Fleetwood. We know that you supplied them.
I don't know nothing about no drugs. All I do is my 10 hair flipping burgers. Can you prove any different?
Yeah, I'd say that the drugs in your thing. I mean,
flipping burgers and strapping jolts of morphine to the bottom of popcorn cups, Fleetwood. Now I want the truth. Who supplies the drugs?
Cat by the name of Armstrong Edwards. He brings his stuff around about once a day.
I know Armstrong. He's a two-bound, strictly small time. Who's he working for, Fleetwood?
Jermaine Jones.
Jermaine Jones. We got a lot of information out of him. All right, now we've got the... Okay. So, number slips recovered. What were they about?
And resisting arrest. Tell us about the numbers if you want our help.
Look, the numbers are the white man's tax on poor folk. All right, now what else you want to know?
He was angry about that. It was the white man's tax on the poor folk. So, is that what he had to pay?
We have an address on the slips. We're gonna go down there now and rat you out, Fleetwood. Tell whoever it is that you rolled over and gave them up.
No. Look, I've been cooperative, okay? Now you gotta help me some.
Fleetwood, I'm gonna speak personally to the judge on your behalf.
A name, Fleetwood.
Look, he's a real slick dude. Wears a hat and swings a cane, goes by the name of Merlin, all right? I ain't got a last name.
See you at the station, Fleetwood.
But you're gonna help me, right?
Of course, kid. You helped us out. We always like to repay a favor. Can you see that Fleetwood gets a nice cell, Wallace? One with a window and a nice fresh pillow.
Alright, he gave us some valuable information there. I'm happy about that. We've got some names and shit. Make a phone call.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Jermaine Jones musical booking agency.
Just a moment, Detective. Jermaine Jones. The office is listed as 5528 Santa Monica Boulevard.
Thanks.
Search the booking agency. Okay.
Solve that big case.
Right, locations. Where we want to go? Numbers operation. I would like to know that. So that would be gambling den and lottery operation. Work address. Gambling and lottery operation. But what does the booking agency got to do with it, other than the fact that he runs it? So we could go down that way. This seems to be a bit a side case, this numbers thing. I don't know how it's connected, but... See, if we go to the operation, might warn Jones, but I don't know. Fuck it, let's go there.
You're behind the wheel.
Again, I'm letting him do all the driving, fuck it.
I heard you were in the blue room the other night. Shouldn't you have been at home? Tucked in bed with the wife and kids?
Where I go is your business.
It couldn't have had anything to do with a certain delightful but damaged German girl, could it?
I don't know what you're talking about, Roy.
Oh, he hit her, didn't he? The guy, the vice dude, I think hit her, or someone hit her. I think it was him. Hit the German woman. Maybe he likes her singing. AM, what an ungodly hour. But what is it with all these slips, and why do junkies have them? That's what I would like to know. I have no idea what it's about, so... Going in like a greenhorn, as the Americans would say.
Detectives Phelps and Earl, LAPD.
The name's Merlin Odie. I run a strictly legitimate bookmaker's detective.
So that's not an illegal wire service that your colleagues are running? And the number slips that I've been picking up all morning with this address on them have nothing to do with you?
I pay my kick to the Watts, and they pay their cut to the LAPD. You can't go shaking me down.
You're a loudmouth motherfucker, aren't you? Anyone ever tell you that criminals are supposed to keep their mouths shut? Stay where you are while we look around.
So he pays off the cops already, and we're supposed to get a cut. But right away, he sang like a bird, and the vice guy didn't like that one bit. Nothing up with it. Hold on. Shit. That is not it. Nope. Damn, man, we're not getting anything, are we? Come on. This sucks. Something Cherries win. Hold on. Go back to the clues. Doodle. Cherry Bell. That was it. We're looking for the bell. Come on, you bastard. Damn. Sorry, guys, it is what it is. Bingo. Well, 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 what do I have here? A load of slips. Payout on 4/2/29 Monday night.
Paper trail, Merlin.
Nice. So where did he get the morphine from?
With this quantity, we're looking at a high-level trafficking charge.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, that's actually quite a win for a dime, Merlin. You better start
God
talking.
God damn it! Get after him, Phelps.
Give it up, Audie.
Wait, okay, I've completely lost him. Oh, there he is. Come on, bitch.
Stop right there, Audie, or I will shoot.
Ah, I kind of got a gun. Alright, whatever. Damn. Motherfucker can run. Man, I'd never be able to be a police officer. I would never be able to be a police officer. Like, shit. Wouldn't make it. Have a heart attack. I got a stitch already.
What are you trying to do, Merlin?
Merlin, we know where your business operations is. We know where your home is. What are these ignorant fucks on the street? I'm trying to catch up with this motherfucker hardcore. Like, come on. This motherfucker don't tire, does he? Oh my god, this guy's gonna run forever. Piece of shit. Damn. Had to come to a close sometime. Shit.
Alright, relax, motherfucker, you got me.
Nice wand, Merlin. Too bad you couldn't pull off your vanishing act.
Make your joke, smart guy, but don't damage that. That there's a valuable antique.
You don't say. Maybe you ought to have a look at this, Cole.
Just sank inside it. Looks simple enough, like a duck face. Ah, what do we have here?
Audie has Jose Ramez in his pocket. Ramez must have forgotten his lucky numbers.
The sum of $231. No sense. To pay. Okay. So he owes that money.
Would you like to calculate the odds on you going to prison for a very long time, Merlin?
I'm not going nowhere. I've paid my contributions, and I'm not getting hustled by you.
We don't want money. We just want information.
We're only interested in morphine. Army surplus morphine. What do you have to say about that?
I heard about that. Big robbery on the ship. Ain't my line of work. I prefer something with a sporting outcome.
Really?
Okay, Merlin, behave like a moron. The two dead guys. I'm telling the DA that you sold them the hop. Are you hearing this?
Loud and clear, motherfucker. I have chips, and I'm not throwing my cards in this easy.
I owe notes from Ramos?
Seems to owe you a lot of money.
We all owe somebody.
Truth, Merlin. Do you know that stealing that surplus is a federal beef? That means that all the payoffs will count for nothing if the feds get involved. Do you want that kind of heat?
How do you think you can tie someone like me into a major operation like that?
Well... he ain't a dude, is he? Well, I don't know. I don't know, y'all, you know, I don't know. I'll try it.
Done jibber jabbering with you.
Fuck. Got it wrong.
You're not the guy we want, Merlin.
Fuck.
We're taking you in. Maybe some time in a cell will help you remember something worthwhile.
Fuck you, and fuck you. You'll never put a charge on me.
Take this bum in.
Damn it.
Take the long way around. And don't be gentle with him. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Well, I fucked that up totally.
You know the way. You can drive.
All right. Where to?
Booking agency? I don't know. I fucked that up either way, guys. My bad.
Hopgood doing, Roy?
Who?
Marlon Hopgood. Your informer. He was my corroborating witness in the Bishop case.
Oh, right. Marlon. You're not still sore about that, are you? You made the case without him.
He was an accessory to the abuse of the girl, Roy.
As long as Hollywood exists, it's gonna be chewing up starry-eyed little girls. Marlon was small time. You caught the big fish. And look how much good it did your career.
True. It doesn't matter if we're there or not. It's always gonna happen. It happens today, so... it's just the way it is, unfortunately. The industry. The world. I'm annoyed that I didn't get those questions right, though, for that guy. Maybe I shouldn't have accused him and just went hard again.
Look at this place. I'm guessing not much talent comes out of this talent agency.
Yeah. J. Jones, 238.
Here we are. Jermaine Jones, 238.
Everyone seems to run from Vice, don't they? Wait, what? Where the hell did guy go? Oh.
Hey! Who let you in?
Well, I'm trying to speak to the dude.
Jermaine Jones!
Yeah.
Don't bother getting up. Your flunky Fleetwood Morgan just snitched you out.
I wasn't planning to. Now you think you could tell me who the hell you are?
LAPD. We'd like to take a look around.
The hell you will, motherfucker. You carrying a warrant?
No, do we need one? Search the place, Cole.
All right.
What do you think you're gonna find, policeman?
Huh? Scott Phantom. Fine radio. Shortwave, AM and FM. My father has a Scott.
Interesting.
You ain't allowed to do this.
Interesting. Hold on.
I got rights.
We had a clue saying always listen to FM. FM. Wait, what am I turning here? I don't know what I'm turning. Hold on. Here we are. Let's wait. Bingo. Well, well, well.
No wonder this thing is sounding a little muffled, Jermaine.
Brennan! Wilt! Get over here! Take these assholes apart.
So we've got a fight on our hands. You gonna take on Vice?
Is this the best you got?
Aw, oh, man! Never gonna get that trophy while I don't get my hat knocked off.
Come on,
fuck.
Come on, beat these sons of bitches down!
This isn't gonna end well for you, friend. Oh. Sit tight, asshole. Pretend you're at the parlor getting your nails done. Cole, you better search through that stuff in the radio before you brace our friend here.
Alright, let's have a little look. Big pile of cash.
How many starving musicians pay with perfect clean 50s?
Yeah.
Too much for felony possession. I'm thinking intent to supply.
Yes, indeed. Hold on. I want this here. Oddie's payout on the 392.
Frank Fleetwood was also a betting man, Jermaine.
Ah. Romero's removals.
They must have taken special care delivering this for you.
Yes, indeed. That's it. So we've got an address on Romero's operation. Now we can talk to him, but before we go there...
Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Yeah, all right, that's fine. I thought so.
I hope none of this stuff is purloined, Mr. Jones.
I have a receipt for that thing. Somewhere.
We just have a little look around the office before we chat to him. Okay.
Lamont and Tyree are dead. At a stretch, the DA could have you on felony murder for supplying stolen government
money. Tyrone and Cornell are dead?
They're on a slab downtown with the ME examining their last meal. Popcorn washed down with morphine.
You offering me a deal?
I have a pet judge who hates blacks. He'll give you 50 years for your two buddies. Another 30 for stealing from Uncle Sam. You'll be out by the time you're 110. Imagine the changes you'll see.
I get the message. How much is this gonna cost me?
I don't care about the money. I don't want that shit. I just want you... Involvement of what? Okay. It's gonna cost you information again.
Who supplies the morphine?
I don't know nothing about that.
That's horseshit.
I think you and your cronies are responsible for the theft from the wharves. If you want to save your skin, stop lying to us, Jones.
So, I look like some kind of criminal genius to you. That what you're saying, motherfucker? Prove that I was in San Pedro and that I stole that shit.
Well... Well,
you're harassing a colored man because he can't afford the payoffs those white boy gangsters cough up to the LAPD.
Damn it.
What is the link between the morphine and the numbers slips?
There is no link. You're wasting your time here.
That's bullshit.
You either rat out the next link in the chain, or you spend the rest of your life in jail.
Are you gonna put that in writing, asshole?
Damn it, I fucked up everything.
What's the score with Ramez removals?
I brought a radio from there. That's all.
Bullshit.
I think Ramez is part of the distribution chain, Jermaine.
And what have you got that could prove I use Ramez that way?
Well... I don't know.
You're one seriously deluded white boy.
Fuck it. Failed everything.
Have a friend here, how the world works.
I'm rushing it.
We have a deal, right?
We're after the morphine. I'll speak to the DA on your behalf. You have my word.
Damn it. I'm gonna get one star for this shit. I fucked that up, but whatever. Is there a phone here they want me to call? Oh yeah, here we go. So yeah, my bad. I fucked all that up. I should take my time a little bit more. I think I'm rushing this a little bit too much.
Phelps, 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address for Ramez Removals. That's Ramez, R-A-M-E-Z. Thanks for your help.
I think Ramez is the one who stole the shipment.
Solved the big case and got promoted?
He stole the shipment and then he gives it to the other guy, Jones, to distribute among other good dudes. That's what it is.
You can drive.
Do we know where we're going?
Yep.
She wants a 5-star goddamn wedding.
I've got some of these, all of the questions wrong, like 5-6 questions.
So. Stole the army surplus morphine, and they are selling it on the streets?
Looks that way.
But the mob wants returned customers, not corpses. Why haven't they cut the morphine?
Good question, Detective.
This robbery happened months ago, right?
The beginning of the year.
So why are the proceeds suddenly turning up now?
Another good question. But where does it get us? It's like asking questions in the middle of the movie. If you just sit tight and keep your yap shut, you'll find out what happens.
In theory.
We need to follow the evidence.
Yeah. I haven't been doing great at that, I won't lie. In respect to asking questions, I'm disappointed in myself. You kept playing bad cop instead of trying to accuse him of something. Looks like a respectable place.
We're here to see Jose Ramez.
What's it about?
Routine inquiries, sir. Can you tell us where we can find him?
You've missed him. He was in the delivery truck, just went out.
God damn it.
Shit. If you were guilty, why would you run?
GPL.
Sorry.
11K requesting assistance in pursuit of narcotic suspects aboard a GM delivery truck. Commercial license, David Charles, 457.
Roger, 11K.
What does this lunatic think he's doing?
Oh, what the hell? Oh, shit.
Get close and steer him off the tar.
Here comes the cavalry.
We're not playing around here. Take this clown off the road.
Wait, am I? Oh, shit. I'm firing. I got fire. No, wait, no, I'm not. What the fuck?
Don't hit the...
I'm driving, my bad.
Fuck!
Here we go.
I can't take the shot from here, Cole!
Well, I'm only going so far.
Hollywood, get alongside him and take him out!
He's taking out his tires. There we go.
On bare rims.
Damn it, your car got fucked up. My bad.
Show me your hands!
We've got a lot of boys down at the station.
Jose Ramirez, you're being arrested on suspicion of supplying illegal drugs, resisting arrest, and for malicious damage to LAPD property.
Hey, hold your horses. I supply furniture, not drugs. And that thing back there? That was an accident. Some furniture came loose. That's all.
Save it for the DA, Chico.
Keep an eye on him. We're gonna take a look around inside.
He's a cocky son of a bitch, ain't he? Right, we've got now. They seem to. Wow, this is a big place. They're delivering furniture, canvas with drugs. Look for any betting slips. He also has an issue. Ah, where's his next delivery?
Who's been delivering? And who's been delivering here? Any repeat business in the ledger, Cole?
Yeah, the blue room. A church? Really? That might be legit. Funny. Polar Bear Ice Company's repeat business.
Why is Ramirez buying so much ice?
Sorry. Merlinotti, here we go.
Merlinotti is buying a lot of furniture.
It would appear so. Oh, it's this dude. Heir apparent to be Bugsy Siegel. What, Mickey coming? Oh, it's this dude. He's with a cop and he wanted him to do something for him, didn't he? It's like a side story we've been following.
Couldn't you think anywhere else to meet, kid?
We like to choose our ground.
What is that supposed to mean? Huh?
It's something Wellington said at Waterloo. The guys who win normally choose where to fight.
We're gonna fight, kid? The two of you versus my boys here? I love the fight game. I went a few rounds myself. You and your friend, he looks tough, but I don't like your chances. Nah.
We don't have to fight, Mr. Cohen. We have you an infillet.
What the fuck is that? Some kind of steak?
It means my men are in cover, but that they can still shoot you. If those were my orders, you would all be dead now.
Are you kidding me? This is a $200 coat. You got some balls.
Kelso.
I hope you didn't scratch the paint of my new Lincoln.
Mm-mm. These guys are getting out of the dope business, Mr. Cohen. You'll have no more problems from them. The morphine is going to disappear back into the sea.
Hang on. You're getting hasty. There's a lot of dough on offer here.
Thanks for the offer, Mr. Cohen, but we are going to have to politely decline. After today, the morphine is no more.
This isn't the way we normally do business.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Cohen.
Call me Mickey. Are you aware of the risk, huh?
I'm giving it to you straight, Mr. Cohen. There will be no more morphine. We made a mistake and would like to back out gracefully. If you come after us, we will be forced to come after you.
You've been polite up till now, so don't stop making threats.
I don't make threats, Mr. Cohen. I'd like to thank you for your time.
Is that guy your idea of muscle, kid?
There's something you should know about Jack, Mr. Cohen. He killed six Japs hand-to-hand with just a bayonet and a K-bar knife. His outfit, the Six Marines, killed over 100,000 Japs in 3 months in Okinawa, and he was in the thick of it.
Those Japs are little guys, right?
Yes, Mr. Cohen. About your size.
All right. Yeah, apparently Bugsy Siegel. Muscle in on drug. Protection rackets. Slowed and get back out of it. Alright, let's move on. 6 out of 13. Right, so remember, we have to find more. We want to find furniture labeled with drugs and possibly an address on as well. That would be beneficial to us. There's so much of it, though.
What's with the puddle? Where's that trail of water coming from, Cole?
I have no idea. I could barely see shit. It's ice. Let's see where it leads. Okay, so what? It started
way through the back.
Give me a minute, man. I've no doubt about that, but we want some more evidence. Fuck.
Welcome to Furniture Village, where taste comes to die.
Yeah. So we're following the trail still, but again, I'm just searching, being a bit extra, trying to find anything else I can find.
What a pile of junk. My mother would be in heaven. I bet this is the kind of crap you love, Cole. 20 years out of fashion.
Cheeky bastard.
Smells of old people in here.
Aha, what's this? Nope. Like a freezer door.
This is useless. I can't see a damn thing. You need to get up onto the floor above.
Alright. That trail of water was leading somewhere. The lights indicate the crane drop pick. Son of a bitch. I couldn't tell you what I'm doing. Oh, I see. Wait. Oh, he can't see. I don't get it. What does he want to fucking... What have we got to do? Oh, I've got a pig sank up. Oh, I see. Fair enough. This shit is long, so behind these boxes, I assume. I can just get this one. Do we take the base one out, Nate Fury? Or do I need to do it twice? So this take a while, guys. My apologies for that. I'm assuming because this is the only door that's blocked. Well, I can see. I'm hoping this is enough. There we are, get rid of it. Come on. Is that it? I can just get on in? I don't know. Should be enough now. I'm hoping. You bastard. Again, I don't know if what I'm doing is right, guys, so... So annoying. Might be totally wrong. So irritable.
Get down here. There's a cold room in the back.
Yep. I just moved everything. So I was right. Okay.
I think we know where the water's coming from.
Yes, indeed.
You're gonna want to see this.
Cold storage for drugs. Ah.
There's something frozen inside.
A shitload of the stuff.
Well, I'll be damned.
Yes, indeed.
This must be how they transport the morphine.
Bingo, we got him. And they're bringing in a fresh shipment.
PD, leave it right there. Everyone out of the vehicle and put your hands up.
There's something in the ice.
He's making a run for it. Let him have it.
Apprehend him. Doesn't say shoot him.
Clear me some space here.
Where are you, Ramirez? You've tried running once. Alright, I just had to shoot him. Oh.
Take them all to Hollywood Station. Have the ME and tech services go over this place.
Where will you be?
Hunting polar bear.
Right, so that's where we've got to go next.
Hmm.
Fuck. Sorry if this is taking a little bit longer, guys, but there you go. Again, I skipped a lot of the driving around myself.
Is Audi serious? Is the LAPD turning a blind eye to narcotics?
Wouldn't be surprised.
Keep your shirt on, Phelps. Drugs are prohibited. Doesn't mean people don't want to take them. Limiting supply doesn't mean that we have limited demand.
I understand that. I know that the average Joe needs to unwind a little. Let his hair down at the end of the week, but morphine? Heroin?
It's important to demonize Hop, Phelps. Looks good in the papers. But when all is said and done, it's just another chemical like booze. A lot of people in high places think we're doing the city a favor by keeping the dope rolling into Central Avenue. Donnelly certainly believes we need to keep them anesthetized.
Better jobs and opportunities would go a lot further.
Will you listen to yourself?
But it doesn't give the average Joe money like that they can make with the drug, so.
The factory is closed. Has been for years. Not much call for ice anymore with all those newfangled refrigerators.
Save it for someone who wants to hear it. How many janitors carry a gat?
One wave announced we're here.
Yeah, how many janitors carry a gat?
Hands in the air. You're done, my friend.
My brother-in-law hates my guts. Come and get me if you want some daylight through that suit of yours.
Shit. Apprehend the suspect.
I want to get massacred, cocksuckers.
He's around here somewhere.
Damn.
Throw out the guns.
Lou died.
Eyes open. Give me some goddamn cover.
Can someone please just kill these assholes already?
Eyes open. He's around here somewhere.
Damn it.
Wide open here.
Weapons on the ground. Now.
I ain't running out of friends or guns in here anytime soon. Understand?
Give me some goddamn cover.
Damn.
Find some cover. You're pretty brave.
Come on, asshole.
Face here.
How long do you think you can hold out?
Mister?
Shit. Oh, good.
Give me some goddamn cover.
Oh, shit.
You're pretty good. Stay down.
He's still alive. Oh, he's dead. Shit. Let's move on up. Wow, there's loads of it.
I'm gonna put holes in you, asshole.
Move, I got ya.
Come on.
Give me some goddamn cover.
You're surrounded.
One more left. Got a Tommy gun this time. Oh, I see. It goes into movie mode. I want to shoot him with a machine gun.
Dead, Finkelstein. Leave the weapon and put your hands up now.
Put my hands up. Sure. Then what? Cop to peddling the dope, cut a deal, ship me off to the queue? Soon as I get locked up, some old friend puts an ice pick above my ear? No thanks.
Only one other way out, shitheel.
Damn. Oh.
Let's have a look around. Now that we've finally got some peace and quiet. I think I've had enough ice for one day. Until the sky.
Well, shitload
of it. Stuff has got to be worth at least $100,000.
So Finkelstein robbed the ship?
My guess is Lenny took it off their hands. This is big. This is going to make the papers, Phelps. As senior investigator, I'll do the talking.
Well, who would have thought that Roy Earle's handpicked new partner would have turned out to be such a great case man? This is a good result, Phelps. As far as we can tell, Lenny the Fink was moving the morphine across the city and as far north as Frisco. This makes the feds very happy, and it makes Mickey Cohen look bad. I won't lie to you, kid. I like the headlines. I like them a lot. You keep this squad in the papers, and we'll get along just fine.
All right, good shit. First case. I suppose that's it, guys. Sorry it went on for a little bit longer. It felt like it, but... It weren't dragged out, it was just a long case, you know? I got so many questions wrong, I expect to get one star for that. 12 out of 13, questions correct, 2 out of 7, rubbish. 3 stars, respectable. A dead kingpin means nothing without evidence and witness testimony to bolster the case. Well, it is what it is. Right, guys, let's see what the next one is. And then that's going to be another video. Reefer Madness is the next case.
You know a Freddie Calhoun?
Sure, I know
Freddie. Freddie needs money to get out of town. Says he's prepared to blow the whistle on a primo reefer distribution ring. Says he
Has he said how much it's going to cost?
$50.
And the department will front me the $50?
You can put in an expense claim. He's over at Mike Lyman's on Hollywood Boulevard. See what you can find out.
So-and-so needs money and he wants $50. Is that it? To give up some information? Like, that's ridiculous. I know money was money back then, but it's like, surely you want more than that. That is weird. That's what an arsehole. Oh well, it is what it is, a small price to pay for solving the crime, and more celebration for our career or whatever in the city of Vice or whatever, or the Vice Squad. Alright guys, that is going to be the end of this part of the playthrough. I hope you guys are enjoying it. Sorry about the previous case, it was a bit of a pain in the ass. This one was good, in our first case in the Vice Squad as it were. Pretty good, pretty enjoyable, I liked it. Didn't get all the questions right, but it is what it is. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links are in the description below. And I will see you in the next case. Or click the annotation for the next video. And I'll see you next time. Thanks so much for watching.